Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1825B, Bell Curve, Line It Mean, 5 Ways. Hey, this is really an addendum to yesterday's episode 1825, and it goes back to episode 1663, where I showed how to create a bell curve. Someone had said, how do we draw a line at the mean? And in yesterday, episode 1825, XY chart with 2 points. That's not the easiest way to do this. The easiest way to do this is to come here to the drawing tools, insert shapes, just grab a line, and then hover right there, 0.47, hold down the shift key, and drag straight down to the axis, and you have a line. There's other ways to do this. Here we have our first series. I'm going to add a second series, and at the mean, the second series is going to have a point there. So we click on the chart to get the blue outlines, drag the blue outline over to add the second series. All right, and then we want to select that point, so format. Series line, which is selecting that single point right there. And then on the layout tab, we're going to add error bars, more error bar options. We want to go minus only, and a fixed value of whatever the mean height happens to be, so 0.0569. And then 2, minus, click close, and that will draw an error bar at the mean. Another way to go, same thing, same, add the second series, but this time we're going to make the height be 0 for that point. So now we have two lines. Basically, we have the line that's the curve, and then the line at the mean, and then select the chart, layout tab, lines, show high-low lines, and that draws a line from the highest point to the lowest point. Because there are no points here, we get no lines. I really wanted to do this with a drop line, but I can't get it to work. Very frustrating. So if I come here to layout and select series line, which is that single point, and then say that I want to add drop lines, they're adding drop lines to series 1 and series 2. That must just be something with the chart. So to do this with a drop line, and this is as horrendous as the original idea of the XY chart, I'm going to click on the chart and control drag to create a copy of the chart. This version over here is going to be pointing to my height, which is 0 in most cases, but equal to the mean in the second case. So we have that chart now. We're going to format selection, line, no line, click close. Okay, so now we just have the points. Now we can come to layout, lines, drop lines, get that single line there. Two more things we have to do though before we can line these back up. So we choose the chart area, format, shape fill, no fill, and then plot area, format, shape fill, no fill. That makes this chart be transparent, so that way we can see through the chart. All right, so I'm going to control click on the chart, select the chart container, and we'll just use the up arrow key and the left arrow key to get those lined up perfectly. You could do this with a mouse, but it's a lot easier to do it with the arrow keys because you have pixel by pixel control right there. Okay, so now we have, in essence, a drop line, but only from that one point. Boy, it'd be nice if they would let drop lines work from just one series and not the other series. But here we are. Okay, so just a quick addendum to yesterday. Lots of different ways to do that line at the mean, certainly using the insert drawing tools, although it seems to be cheating if you're doing this for your college class. They'll probably think that it's just like, you know, grabbing a pencil and drawing a line in, but lots of different ways to go. Well, yeah, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.